The number 28 is special because it's both perfect and happy. So what do we mean? Let me show you. First, let's talk about what makes 28 perfect. To do so, we will have to look for its factors. So 28, let's write it as 1 times 28. So these are the factors of 28. And we can also do it as 2 times 14. And of course, we can also do it as 4 times 7. And if you just ignore 28, these right here are the proper factors of 28. Now, let's go ahead and add them up. 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 7 plus 14. Guess what? Yes, we are going to get the number 28 back. So whenever this happens, that makes the number perfect. Next, let's talk about what makes this number happy. So this is trickier. Have a look. I'm going to start with 28 and I'm going to form a sequence in the following manner. I'm going to look at the first digit and I will square that, which is 4. And I'm going to look at the next digit, which is 8, and I will square that and we get 64. And then we are going to add them up. So that will give us 68. That's how we get to the next number. Then we'll just keep going, right? This right here gives us 36, and then this right here gives us 64, and when we add them, we get 100. Cool. And then we continue. 1 squared is 1, and this right here is just 0, and this right here is just 0. When we add them up, this right here is just equal to 1. And guess what? If you end up with 1, this is always going to be 1. So we stop right here. Whenever you start with a number and you do this, produce a sequence, if it ends up to be 1, then you get a happy number. So 28 is both perfect and happy. But unfortunately, not all the perfect numbers are happy, not all the happy numbers are perfect. So let me just give you guys an example real quick. 6. You know what? This right here, yes, is perfect. But unfortunately, not happy. Why? Let's have a look. 6, look at this as 1 times 6, and then 2 times 3. And then look for its common factor, the proper factors, 1, 2, and 3. Add them up. Yes, we get 6 back. So it is perfect. Checks. Now, is this happy? Start with 6. It's just by itself, so square that, we get 36. Next, we do this square, which is 9, plus 6 square, which is 36. So we get 45. And then we do 16 plus 25, that will be 41. And then 16 plus 1, which is 17. And then 1 plus 49, which is 50. Okay, 25 plus 0 is 25. And then this is 4 plus 25, which is 29. And then 4 plus 36, which is 40. And then 16 plus 0 is 16. And then 1 plus 36 is 37. And then 9 plus 63 is 70. No, 9 plus 49 is 58. Oh, wow. 25 plus 64 is 89. And then 89, right? So this 64 plus 81 is 155. 1 plus 16, which is 17. And then plus 25 is 42. And then 16 plus 4, which is 20. And then 4 plus 0 is just that. And then square that is 16. And guess what? We see 16 earlier, right? So if you continue, you end up with 37, 58, but these numbers are going to repeat. So we don't have to continue anymore. We just run into this cycle over and over. So unfortunately, 6 is not perfect. I will give you a little sad face right here. Yeah, my marker is also about to run out of ink, so it's also a sad face. So can you think about a number that's both perfect and also happy? Leave a comment down below. That's it.